We live in a world where valuable information for data and AI pipelines is locked inside unstructured data like PDFs. The need to efficiently access and process this data has become increasingly urgent. How can we leverage leading cloud services to unlock the hidden insights within our virtual piles of papers? In this video, we'll explore precisely that using Document AI from Google Cloud. This turnkey AI service can transform our images and PDFs into structured data. This parsed data can then be used in text embedding APIs, AI models, and traditional data pipelines. To utilize this system, we require some PDF files. We'll use the research papers for Palm AI, OpenAI's GPT-4, and the PyTorch paper as examples. After some basic getting started concepts, we'll also show you how you can integrate Document AI into scripts and pipelines. Moving to the Document AI console, we have two distinct methods for processing these documents: using a pre-built processor or creating a custom one. We'll opt for a pre-built processor to keep it simple, and for our research paper scenario, the Document OCR is an excellent choice for us. This specific processor can identify and extract text from a diverse assortment of documents. Once the processor is activated, we can upload a test document, such as our PyTorch paper, to see how the Document AI processor operates and captures structured information. On the right side, we see the PDF file, and on the left, we have some extracted text. This includes items like rotated text, footnotes, headers, and footers. The technology employed here is optical character recognition, which attempts to recognize characters and organize them into meaningful logical blocks. This is fantastic for evaluating how our processor might perform on one or two document samples, but to truly productionalize this, we'll need to use the API. We'll showcase the Document AI API by implementing a simple Cloud Functions instance that triggers on PDF uploads to Google Cloud Storage, parses the PDF, and pushes structured data to BigQuery. So let's start setting up these components. We'll begin with the Cloud Function definition. For the trigger type, we'll use cloud storage and run it when a file is created in the selected bucket. We can create a bucket and name it Research Papers, but make sure your own bucket name is globally unique. We'll name our function Research Papers to BigQuery, and the US Central 1 region should suffice. The default settings for runtime, build, connection, and security are mostly adequate, but we may want to allocate more memory to these functions. We'll develop a Python-based function using the adaptable Document AI APIs. The code will involve the parse to BigQuery entry point, where we'll define some constants. We'll use the Google Cloud Storage client to download the file, the Document AI client to process the document, and the BigQuery client to save the file name and text contents to a table. We'll need to create the research papers and parsed text dataset and table shortly, but let's import the required Python libraries first. While this is being created, let's head over to BigQuery and set up our dataset table. We'll provide an explicit schema with a couple of string fields, skip partitioning and clustering, and create the table. Now let's return to our cloud function, and since it's been updated, we can add a new PDF to our bucket. The processing is quite quick, so if we jump into BigQuery next, we'll see that parsed data come up nicely. We'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. I want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.